إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله تعالى فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الأحد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما مزيدا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء. واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of all the worlds. We give salah and salams on our beloved messenger and on his companions and on those who follow him until the day of judgment. O you who believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he should be feared, and do not die unless you are in the state of Islam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in an authentic hadith, من قال لا إله إلا الله مخلصا من قلبه دخل الجنة. Whoever says لا إله إلا الله with إخلاص, with sincerity from his heart, he goes to Jannah. Whoever says لا إله إلا الله, there is none worthy of worship but Allah سبحانه وتعالى, with sincerity. In order to have sincerity of saying a word, you need to know the meaning of this word. And whoever says it with full conviction, with sincerity from their heart, it shows in their actions and it manifests in the seeds of their work. The Prophet ﷺ says, this person goes to Jannah. And when Iblis was telling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he was going to take a certain people astray, he said, I will take them all with me, إِلَّا عِبَادَكَ الْمُخْلَصِينَ, except for those of your servants, except your slaves, who have been given and achieved ikhlas, sincerity. And this surah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about and has revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to his companions and told them, which one of you would like to recite in a night a third of the Quran? And they said, which one of us is capable of reciting a third of Qur'an? And he said, Surah Al-Ikhlas is equivalent to a third of the Qur'an. This surah, the surah of Ikhlas, is a third of the Qur'an. Therefore, a third of our deen is Ikhlas. And the scholars of hadith start their books of hadith with إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ. Indeed, our actions are based on our intentions. And this ikhlas will restrict us from doing shameful acts and evil deeds. This ikhlas will restrict us from saying haram or doing haram. Because without ikhlas in our salah, there is no salah. Without sincerity in our salah, there is no salah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about Yusuf alayhi salam, when the wife of Al-Aziz came and approached him, he says, كَذَلِكَ لِنَصْرِفَ عَنْهُ السُّوءَ وَالْفَحْشَاءِ إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُخْلَصِينَ. So that we may take away the su'. And Ibn al-Qayyim rahmatullahi ta'ala says here, the su' is the thoughts of doing evil, is the thoughts of doing shameful acts. Because later on, Umar Abdul Aziz says, إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِالسُّوءِ. Our nafs, our soul, is full of these thoughts that are evil. إِلَّا مَا رَحْمَ رَبِّي. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He takes away from him, from Yusuf alayhi salam, as-su' these thoughts, وَالْفَحْشَاءَ these shameful acts, and these are usually referred to as fornication and adultery. Why? إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُخْلَصِينَ. Indeed, he is from our servants who has achieved ikhlas, who has achieved sincerity. And we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. Your salah, it restricts one from doing shameful acts and evil deeds. So when we are making our salah, and we're finding that there is a problem with us still, and we still find it easy to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then it's time to go and review how sincere we are when we make our salah. Is it a salah that I'm saying Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen and I'm thinking about my DTE bill? I'm thinking about my wife and kids. I'm thinking about the house and car. I'm thinking about this job, this project that isn't completed yet. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ. Indeed, Allah does not forgive one who commits shirk with Him. And He forgives everything else for whoever He wishes. Now this shirk can be even when we are making salah, because we are associating a partner with Allah. We're not just praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're praying with our actions, but our heart is somewhere else. Our heart at that moment is given to someone else. So then after we're done with salah, we wonder why it becomes so easy to take away the rights of other people. We wonder why it becomes so easy to do haram, and we know that the eye of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching us. It's because our actions lack ikhlas. And when we don't have ikhlas, consistency is taken away from us. Barakah is taken away from us. The fullness of our deeds and actions is taken away from us. And we'll find that a person who makes salah, and they make salah without ikhlas, we're just talking about salah, nothing else. They make salah without ikhlas, you'll find that this person in secret, it's more difficult for them to make salah than in open. This person will find themselves thinking about getting up in the middle of the night to pray, but never being able to do it. This person will think about doing righteous acts and righteous deeds and never being able to accomplish it. Why? Because of their lack of ikhlas. And inshallah ta'ala, I want to talk about some points, bi'idhnillah ta'ala, some minor points on different things that we can do in order to achieve ikhlas. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأستغفره إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد. First and foremost, our deen is based on ikhlas. As a matter of fact, the first of the pillars of Islam is based on ikhlas and obedience. Ikhlas and obedience. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. I testify, I bear witness that there is no one and nothing worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This sentence here gets rid of every type of shirk. And the absence of ikhlas, my dear brothers and sisters, is shirk. Ikhlas means to purely worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for Him alone, and nothing else, and no one else. وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. He is the one who came to teach us the laws that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us for us to obey. Then comes the pillar of salah. So without it, there is no salah. As a matter of fact, during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a man prayed badly. And he prayed fast. And he didn't give each and every position its due rights. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, get up and pray again because you didn't pray. And he did it again. He said, get up and pray again because you didn't pray. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I only know of this prayer. I don't know of any prayer other than this. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught him. And this is a hadith that's very famous, and we should go inshallah ta'ala to research this hadith. So as for the different methods, inshallah ta'ala, and this is just a few, subhanAllah, there are so many. But I want to, inshallah ta'ala, leave us something that I can benefit with. Me, personally. Number one. Let's take from a very famous hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna ahadakum yajma'u khalqahu fi batni ummihi 40 yawman nutfa, thumma yakunu 'alaqa mithla dhalik, thumma yakunu mudghah mithla dhalik, thumma yawsilu ilayhi al-malak fa yanfukhu fihi ar-ruh." Indeed, one of you are in the wombs of your mother. They're collecting themselves as a creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for 40 days as a liquid, then they become a clot, then they become a leech-like clot, a leech-like piece of flesh. So each time is 40 days. And subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changes this creation of His to become something else until it develops completely for 40 days. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says in an authentic hadith, whoever comes and witnesses the takbir of ihram, the first takbir of the salah, for every salah, for 40 days, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will write on him two different things that he will be innocent from. Number one, he will be innocent from the fire. Number two, he will be innocent from النفاق, hypocrisy. One of the great tabi'is, rahmatullahi alayhi, he said, ما أخلص عبد القط أربعين يوما إلا وأنبتت ينابيع الحكمة على لسانه. Whoever becomes sincere for 40 days, there's no one that becomes sincere for 40 days without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala manifesting the signs, the fruits of hikmah, wisdom on his tongue. And وَأَبْصَرَهُ عُيُوبَ الدُّنْيَا, and he sees, he's able to see with a clear sight the defects of this lowly life. And he's able to know its harms and the cures for these harms. So let's take these 40 days as an example. Our development changes every 40 days. And it becomes complete after 40 days. And then it changes again to become complete for another 40 days. So let's take from this inshallah time and say, okay, from today, February 14th, 2014, I will start my first 40-day thing until I get istiqamah, firmness. What am I going to do? Start simple. I will make every salah on time for 40 days. Because if you cannot do the things that you have to do, let's forget about everything else. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us fara'id, things that we must do. And we want to make 1,000 rak'ahs in a day, but yet we can't keep up with our dhuhr salah, our fajr on time, our isha on time. We are combining them every day. And sometimes we say, oh well, it's gone, I'll make it up another day. Let's focus on these 5 salahs first. If you've achieved that for 40 days, then add something else. Say, okay, now I'm going to make the sunnah for fajr and the sunnah for isha, 40 days. Don't break it. And make sure you're doing it only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if not, then you will be inconsistent, I guarantee. And then if you've done that for 40 days, add the sunnahs for another salah. Until you're making all of your sunnahs. And then add 10 after 40 days. Then add 10, 10 minutes for qiyam al-layl. That's another 10 minutes. Believe me, by the time the year is over, you are making all of your salahs in the masjid on time with the sunnah and getting up in the middle of the night. Versus going for 20 years of being in Islam and not being able to accomplish making salah on time. Then you can add fasting. Let me fast Monday, every Monday. One day, 40 days, maintain it. Then do Monday and Thursday, maintain it. Then add the middle of every month, maintain it, 40 days. And don't add something until you've completed the 40 days. And be careful not to do, be careful and don't start something and not continue with it. The Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum hated to start a good deed and not be able to continue with it. So once you start it, inshallah ta'ala, you will be, and you're persistent with it, it becomes a habit, it becomes easy for you. You feel when you leave it like you're soaked in filth and dirt. This is a hint that your heart has been purified. When you can no longer stay away from ibadah. When all you want is the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After 2-3 years, you'll find that from the moment you wake up in the morning until the moment you go to sleep, you cannot go for 1 second without the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, one of the signs of the believers is that his tongue will stay soaked from the remembrance of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among them. And when you are consistent and persistent in your ibadah, perhaps you will be one of the people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows to go into Jannah from whichever gate He wishes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those people. So the key element here is ikhlas, sincerity. And there is no sincerity without proper actions. So we need to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with sincerity. Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam based on what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا أَتَاكُمْ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. Whatever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave you, take it. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't leave us anything good without him telling us about it. And he never left anything that's bad without warning us from it. So he said, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, whatever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought you, then take it. And whatever he prohibited you from, then stay away from it. And fear Allah. Don't worry about people. Don't worry about the job. Don't fear Allah. Because Allah is al-Razzaqu al-Quwwatul Mateen. He's the provider. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most severe in punishment. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا وأخطأنا. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به. واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة.